I'm going to speak about Lag B'Omer. What is, you know, how you klal yisrael, see them, snag them, svar them, you know, it there's all of them. And it's one of the most amazing things. Celebrate Lag B'Omer. It's unbelievable. They come from all over, thousands of people. The question is, like, there must be something very, 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 very deep about this, something very significant. Klal Yisrael, entire Klal Yisrael, feel something. So, you know, so many ways to explain it. I want to say over a famous Torah Rav Nachman Breslov said right before he died. Beginning of the Kutim Aran, there's a famous Torah what he said right before that he died. He said, if Shimon b'Yichui, Hiftach, he promised, Shleishtakech Torah Yisrael al Yudai. The Torah will not be forgotten through him. Shimon b'Yichui said this. Kemim b'Gemura, Gemura says like this. Kenechnesi Rabbi Seini leKerem b'Yavne. They went into Kerem. Kerem means like it was a vineyard. Yavne was the place in Eden was sitting then. And Omri, see the Torah shenishtakech miso. The Torah is going to be forgotten in Klal Yisrael. So they said, so the Gemara, Umar Reb Shimon b'Yichui, shloi tishtakech. The Torah will not be forgotten. Shenema kiloi shishukach b'pi zaroi. The Torah is not going to be forgotten. Now, it's an amazing thing that the Sanhedrin and Tai Sanhedrin said the Torah will be forgotten. And Shimon b'Yichui says, absolutely not. The Torah is not going to be forgotten. So it's an amazing thing. And history shows the Torah is talking not forgotten. You see, we have the Torah. One of the most amazing things is after such an incredible Harbin, destruction of Europe, what happened 75 years ago, it hasn't happened, even the Harbin B'Samigdash, many say. It was a horrendous 6 million Jews killed, another 6 million make sick. It was just a horrendous destruction. The Torah is still being learned. It's amazing. Isn't it amazing? Which nation could say such a thing? The Torah is still being learned. Which nation could say they went into Golis and people are just moving back to the homeland? I always tell people, I don't care if you're Tzioni, I don't care if you're the Turekarta. The reality is, we were in Golos 2,000 years, and the reality is, people picked themselves up, Jews came back. Okay, the Chinese people say they're 2,000 years in Golos in America, and they move back to China. Oh, no, they move back to, you know, they come here, and they settle, and they're here. This is an amazing thing, how it doesn't make a difference. This is our land. This is, and the Torah is a living Torah. So Rav Shimon b'Yichui got up and said, the Torah is not going to be forgotten. The Yavetz says in his Sefer that for him, the greatest ness of all miracles is that the Torah is not forgotten. He says, the longer Jews in the Gula is, the bigger the ness. The Yavetz is a very, very renowned writer. He writes, that means the fact that the Torah is not being forgotten, that we learn Torah. They're in LA. And people are arguing Hilchos Shabbos, but no matter how, but Torah is being learned. That's the unbelievableness. It's an incredibleness that we still are the way we are. So he says, Kamibi Bezoi, the Zoi says, Bahai Chabira, the Sefer Leif Kamin Goyglusim, Shimon B'Yichui said even more, this Sefer is going to help us go out of Gulas. But not only help our Gula, the Sefer is going to help make sure the Torah is not going to be forgotten. So he says, "Va'atu boy re'e." Look, the Rav Nachman says the famous thing. The look how the meru is in the pusik. Ki loy shishukach is the Sefer Tevis Yoichui. Ki loy shishukach mizaroi is the Sefer Tevis Yoichui. Zaroi, the one is mentioned over here. His zaroi. The Zara that's mentioned, through him, the Torah is not going to be forgotten. You understand? Kiloi shishukach mepi Zaroi. Zaroi is Yechui from through him. To the Koyach of Shem v'Yechui, the Torah is not going to be forgotten. He says, because with this Koyach of the Zoya, so that's why I always say we celebrate it, because we see all the time the Torah is not forgotten. We live, we see it's not forgotten. It's a miracle. What, not only the Torah is not forgotten, what connects us Jews to every other type of a Jew? You know, that means a Yid comes and you know, it comes, you know, we could, you could walk, the first time I went to Etzel, I was young. It was just astonishing. You walk in the Svardish Yeshua, read Svardish Yeshua, everyone is davening. Same Mishnah Berurah, same Rambam, same Gemara. The Torah connects us in all four corners. And that's the koyach of Rishim B'Yechui that in him. Now, we have no idea what the Rishim B'Yechui is. We have zero, but I'm going to say something very interesting. And in the what's his name? We sing Bar Yechui. You know, it's Bar Yechui, Nimshach L'Ashrechu, Shem and Susim Echem. He mentions Bar Yechui the whole time. It's a wondering book. They see a counter, this word from Nachum and Breslov seems like through Yechui, somehow his father Yechui, but he says, Kiloy Shishukim Bizarro, the Zaro of Yechui looks like his father was very great. This is, I don't know, I have no idea. I looked at who Yechui, I don't think Chazal mentions much of it. But in the Zohar, there's a frightening Zohar, Kudish. The Zohar says, one time, Shem Yechui sees this enormous Malach Mazik, he wants to destroy the world. So he says to the Malach, go up and say to the Rebbeinu Shaloylam, Bar Yechui is in this world, the son of Yechui in the world, I'll take care of it. Now go up. It's interesting. He mentions Bar Yechui. Now, very interesting. It doesn't say Shem is in this world and Bar Yechui. Somehow, that koyach, though for some reason, the hidden koyach of Shem Yechui is then. Now, what does the mean? I want to explain something in a very simple way, and I'll try to explain it in a very deep way. You know, very few people know Kabbalah. So what does it mean that Shem B'Yechui, with his koyach, we make sure the Torah is not going to be forgotten? To explain in a simple way, I'm going to say something, a very interesting Ramban, to explain this. The Ramban says that Iyev was written, for one reason Iyev was written. Iyev was written that many people have a lot of tzoras in life, a lot of pain in life. People go through, and the question is, why me? That's the famous question. Why me? Before I even say the Teretz, I want to say something very, very, very profound. That after the Zohar was Nizgal and Ibshim, and the Rizal explained the Zohar, this changed the outlook of the entire Klal Yisrael, how to look at pain. Used to be a person's in pain, didn't know how to look at it. Why me? You know, I met someone recently. He lost two wives already. He lost two wives. He's younger than me. Two wives that he lost, and one child is very sick. One child never get married. I mean, sort of is what he described to me. So the question is always, why me? So this, the Ramban says, Iyev was written that way. And what is the answer to Iyev, why me? The Ramban says it's a secret. You understand the Ramban? You write a whole sefer, and I'll soon tell you the secret, but the Ramban writes, we write a whole sefer Iyev, that even though Iyev was such a tzaddik, look at him, and what's the answer to the question, why me? It's a secret. The reason is, if we do know there was such a big tzaddik who lived and had such pain, and there was an answer, it calms us down too. Makes you, all right, there was someone who lived there. The real answer we do know from the Zohar and the Rizal, the Sotah Gilgal. So if a person is born not well, person is, you know, certain times, sorrows to get, sometimes we don't have to go to the Gilgal, we sin in this world. But sometimes abnormal sorrows, you see people born sick. And so that sickness, that comes, that really comes from the Sotah Gilgal, I said. Anyways, so that means that the Ramban is saying that we, Iyev was written the sefer. Somehow there's a sefer written, a difficult sefer. Anyone who learns Iyev, it's not such easy, but there's an answer to the thing. And Shem B'Yechui, just because he was so big, somehow it has an impact on everything that we do. But in truth, the Kita Luchas keeps on saying this in the Kita Luchas, the Tzedikim B'Mesusam Yosef B'Chayayim, and they continuously bring down Kedusha in this world. If it wouldn't be for the Kedusha of the Zohar, we would have never been existed. The Zohar is so holy that, you know, all the Chassidic Sforim is built on it. Every Chassidic Sforim is built on the Chassidus and the Zohar. That we have just, people don't realize what we learn from the Zohar is just the droplets. You know, the Kabbalah is so deep. But the droplets that we learn, that has a Kedusha, that brings a fire. Why do you make a fire in the Shem B'Yichui? Because the fire, the Eish of Yiddishkeit, this is what Shem B'Yichui brought down. You know, that he brought down a love, a fire, a passion to Yiddishkeit. You know, that's what the Koich of the Kedusha is. According to the Zohar, the main Kedusha is the Shminas Abris. And unfortunately, before Mashiach comes, this is the biggest challenge that we all have. Al Kapunim, what the Shem B'Yichui Koich was, that he brought such a Kedusha into the world with this Torah. You know, the times of Shem B'Yichui, the Zohar keeps on saying they've met young children who would say secrets of the Torah. And Reb Chiya would cry, he says, because you are alive, Reb Shimon. Because you are alive, even young children learn how to say secrets of the Torah. But why, when are you going to leave? He used to cry. But the truth is that even though Reb Shimon B'Yichui left, there's certain neshumas that stays with us. And that neshuma helps us in the hardship of the Golas, that there's still a burning fire that we have that is burning. I want to say over. I saw this in the Bnei Soscha once. I don't remember where. But he quotes from the Balami Kibbulah, a Mavul Digazach. He says that the Shimon B'Yichui should have been from the Surah Riga Malchus too. Should have been. Like Reb Kiva and all these great things. He brings down. Just he says that Reb Shimon B'Yichui did with his Kabbalah. Now, the Rizal says, a Mavul Digazach, that every year, almost, the Koyach of Reb Kiva that died in Kiddush Hashem, that Koyach still exists for us. It's not that Reb Kiva died in Kiddush Hashem just then. The Koyach that he died has an impact for us even now. It brings Kedusha, whatever they're supposed to be accomplishing, it does. Rizal explains in Deep Kabbalah. So he says, what Reb Shem B'Yichui really did with his Kedusha of the Torah that he showed, you don't have to die in Kiddush Hashem, that with the Kedusha of the secrets of the Torah, he showed that the power of the... Because Reb Shem B'Yichui, what was the greatness of Reb Shem B'Yichui? That the Kedusha was that it was Kodesh Kedusha, that he was in total Kodesh, and not just Kodesh Kedusha, but it was that the Kedusha was, he was Shemes Kodesh. The Gemara says that Reb Shir Belevi met Reb Shimon B'Yichui, famous Gemara. So you know the famous Shir Belevi went up in the Shemayim alive. Let me say over the Gemara to understand this Gemara. Gemara says like this: Reb Shir Belevi met Eliyahu Novi, a pischoy the pischoy of the Mar Reb Shimon B'Yichui. That means in the cave Reb Shimon B'Yichui is buried. Reb Shir Belevi meets Eliyahu Novi. She says, asks Eliyahu, when is Mashiach coming? He says, go ask Mashiach himself. Go ask him. So he says, a long story of Mashiach Belevi. He says, go ask him, where will I find? Tells him where you're going to find Mashiach, and you know who's Mashiach, and ask him, when is he coming? So, Amos Samar, when are you coming? He says, Hayoim, I'm coming today. Comes back to Eliyahu HaNavi. He says, what did Mashiach tell you? He says, I'm coming today. He said, he lied to me. Today, the day passed and he didn't come. Nah, you misunderstood. Because Hayoim and Mikoyle Tishmori. So Rav Nachman asks, I'm going to get back soon there to Shiva Levi and other Nakuda, but Rav Nachman says, I'm waiting to get Zach on this thing. He says, what is a joke over here? You know, young children do this, you know, haha. I said, Hayoim, you know, the children have this game where they play with each other. And there's a game. He says, Hayoim. And he doesn't go. He meant to say, if a person would know I only have to live today, he could overcome all the manias. The fact that I have to, you know, it's another day and another day, it's too much. You tell yourself, all I do is live today, you can accomplish what you want. You get up early morning, you can daven. The Yitzhahara's power is that it's another day and it's, oh, wow, I'm going to do it every day. You don't know how long you can be living. First of all, beginning, everything is difficult. Color school is suspicious. But if you tell yourself, all I have is today, then you can accomplish anything. That's how you make it. Anyways, the Gemara goes on another place in Ksubas. The Shir Malevi went into Gan Eden alive. He meets Shem Baruchui, and Shem Baruchui asks him, Bar Levua, is it true you're the son of Levi? Yes. Did you see a Keshes B'chayev? Was there ever a rainbow? Because the Gemara says, B'chayev the Shem Baruchui, there was never a Keshes, because he was the son of the Tikkun Abris. So Shem Baruchui was the, what does it mean? The passion that he had, he put totally in Yiddishkeit, he put it. So Reb Shimon Yehuda showed that he went with the Kedusha, Shekedusha, Kedusha, that he was able to accomplish what? That's what he brings down the Bnei Soschan. What the Reb Kiva did, the Mesiris Nefesh, Reb Shimon Yehuda was able to do with the Kedusha. You know that in Breishis, as Merimis, Rashbi Aleph Tuf. Breishis is Oisius, Reb Shimon Bar Yehuda. I once added many years ago that also in the Breishis Merumbes Rasha, the Pshloime Ben Yitzchuki, because without Rasha, the Torah wouldn't have forgotten. The same letters, Rasha, in Nigla, without Rasha, the Torah wouldn't have forgotten. Rasha made sure. Rasha, the Kitabran says, Rasha is the brother of Klal Yisrael. Wherever we go, Rasha is with us. The same way, many of them said, what is it, the Chassidus should bring Rav Shimon Bar Yochai? That his koyach was such a koyach, and the fact that we learn, the fact is the Yiddish guy, it was his koyach that he says from the Zohar that he brought. So, you know, so what do we do need to celebrate? One of the things, one of the important things what Rav Shimon Bar Yochai said, taught continuously, I'm going to say this over. Shem B'chui kept on saying in the Zohar all the time, you have to be b'simcha. You have to be happy. So I want to explain something very, very, very interesting about this. You know, it says that Shem B'chui was 12 years in the cave. I think 12 years in the cave, Shem B'chui. Also, the Chazal say that Kiva had 24,000 Tamidim. Remember, 24,000 Tamidim. What is this 12 and 24,000 Tamidim? 24,000 Tamidim who died from, what's the name, from till like Boimer, the Lushin HaMedrash seems like an entire Oimer, but we think that like Boimer it stopped. And what is the number 24? We continuously have 24. We have just learned the Daf Yoimi, there's Chuv Dalas Mishmoiris. The Gemara says an interesting thing, but Shem B'chui came out of the cave. It says he met his father-in-law, Pinchas ben Yui. And he says that his father-in-law was washing him, and his Shem B'chui was in the cave, and he never took a bath. So his skin was cracked terrible. See, we think Shem B'chui was in the cave. Miracles happened to him. It's like he bathed himself every day. No. The miracle happened. He had a well of water and a boxer tree. That's all he had. That's a miracle. But he didn't have no showers, no nothing. So his skin was terrible cracked, and tears were coming down on Pinchas ben Yair, and Shem B'chui was screaming, ouch, you know, tears are salty, and it really hurt him. So Pinchas ben Yair says to him, oh, that I see you this way. So Shem B'chui says, it's great that you see me this way. I wouldn't have been zoicha to everything, because in the 12 years that he was in the cave, he was zoicha, the Zohar Kodesh says, to bring down all the secrets of the Torah. Eliyahu Hanavi would come twice a day and learn with him Torah. That's why his Gala, all the Neshamas came to teach him Torah. That's how so the Gemara goes on. Because before Reb Shimon Chui went into the cave, he asked his father-in-law a question. His father-in-law answered him 12 answers. Now that he came out of the cave, his father-in-law asked him a question. He answered 24 answers. Something 24. The famous Gemara by Rabbi Yochanan Shlokish. Gemara also says that he was able to answer, yes, 24 questions and 24 answers. What is this 24? Let me explain something. This would answer a mystical thing. It says, the Bnei Shloilem took Chava v'yuvayu el Udom. Bnei Shloilem took Chava and born to Udom Arishon. The Baal HaTurim says on the place, it's really a Zohar Kodesh, v'yuvayu is gematri chuv dalet tachshitim. He bought her. Now you really think he bought Chava dressed up with the Chuvdal Tachshitim? You know, the reason why wife needs earrings is because other women wear earrings. If you're the only lady in the world, you don't need earrings. That's how it is. You're the only lady in the world. As I always tell people, how did Uda Menashe make shalom with his wife? She killed him. He said, that she murdered me. So how did he make shalom with his wife? Imagine your wife not just wanted to murder you, was going to live forever. And now he's going to die. And he blamed his wife. You know what? If it's the only lady in the world, you can make shalom. Because as soon as you think there's another lady in the world, then you cannot have shalom. It's the only lady in the world, you can make shalom. Anyways, he bought Kov Dara Tachshitan, means spiritual Tachshitan. That's what it means. I'll explain a little bit soon. Then the Zohar Kodesh says, Ve'eva ushes beina beincho. He told Chava, Ve'eva is gematri Chov Dalet. Chov Dalet koichas atuma. There was Chov Dalet koichas at Kedusha, Chov Dalet koichas atuma. Ve'eva, and the Zohar Kodesh says, it goes into a lot of secrets in the Torah, but the Zohar says, Ve'eva means, you know, there's a famous question that we all have. Why aren't we smiling all day long? I want to tell you something, Rabbi Isai. No one lived such a great life as we do since Uda Marisha was kicked out of Gan Eden. Imagine I'm sitting in front of a Zoom and I have a bunch of people listening to me and I'll record it. Try to tell this to your grandfather, a Zoom. You know, if you try to explain to your grandfather, my own grandfather lived before the war, and he tried to tell him, he says, after 2 hours explained, he said, this is Kishif. No, that doesn't mean. People listening all over, and you could send it, you could see me. You couldn't imagine such a thing. We have unbelievable life, and we kvetch like people living in the villages that don't have a team. That comes from the klola, the eva usis. There's an eva. Because Udam Rishi was Choyta, so Betsuva Toichlenu, so there is a person is not naturally happy. This is one of the Menachem Breslov says the Salam in the Zohar Kodesh, it's based on the Zohar. The Zohar says we're not naturally happy, we are naturally kvetchy people. The only ones are happy if you conscientious decide to be happy. Because there's the Eva, that the curse after the Chet Udam Rishi, we have this Eva. That's where you notice women suffer from depression much more than men. It's a fact, because they got the Eva that was said to her. So that's always the Chuv Dalet. Chuv Dalet Mishmoides, that's why you have Chuv Dalet. Chuv Dalet Tanakh is made of Chuv Dalet. It's always Chuv Dalet, because the Chuv Dalet Metunas Kahuna is also that way. It's always the Meramis, it's connected. It's too complicated to explain it, but it's all connected because there is a tikkun of the Chuv Dalet, the Eva of that Gad. The tikkun is to make yourself happy. The Zohar Kodesh says, Amuri de Gezach. No mitzvah could fly up to Shemayim unless you do it besimcha. So the Zohar asked the interesting question. So when a person does tshuva, how's that tshuva go up? You can't be smiling when you do tshuva. Can be besimcha, I'm doing besimcha tshuva. You gotta come with a broken heart. So the Zohar says, when the Kohen, the Leviim do the avodah b'smigdash, their simcha in mitzvah to the tshuva and it goes up to Shemayim. So the Zohar Kodesh asks, very nice, b'sman b'smigdash kayim, b'sman shem b'smigdash kayim, how does the tshuva go up? So the Zohar says, singing by learning, that brings up the tshuva to Shemayim. That means it doesn't happen by itself. You have to have the simcha. I mean, this is one of the most important things that Rav Shem Tov took from the Rizal, from the Zohar, is that we have to push ourselves to be happy. That's what the fire we dance on. And if you ever went to Meron, people dance and they sing. And Baruch Hu, you think the happiness, the singing, that kept Yiddishkeit. That the truth is, in a house where you sing Zmiris, in a house where you're happy, Yiddishkeit is alive. This is what Reb Shimon Choydim, he brought in the love of Yiddishkeit, you know, in Golas, you know. I always said over the famous vote from the Kotzke Rebbe. The Kotzke Rebbe asked once a child, where is God? So says, what is God? You know, if you get God is here and God is there and Hashem is there and Hashem is everywhere. Where is he? He says, God is where you let him in. One of the hardest things for us in Yiddishkeit is to have a relationship with the Rabbanu Shalom. You could learn entire Shas. You could learn the most difficult sugyas in Shas. And you could know it. But to have a relationship with God and say, I am close to Hashem, who thinks about Hashem? It's so far removed from our mind. This is what the Shimba Yechui and the Rizal, when the sister told the show, Hashem is really here all the time. And Hashem really loves you. The Kita Luchas keeps on saying always that the Koich of Tzaddik was to show the man how far gone we are. The Koich of Shimba Yechui and the Koich of the great Tzaddikim was that even how far the Neshama has gone, he could always bring him back. Because the famous about in a such shemaim, if I climb heavens, you're there, and I see a shaol hineko, you're also there. You know, I always tell people that Yankev Avini, the Rabbani Shem told Yankev Avini, hine unoichi imoch, I am with you, ishmartichu, I'll watch you b'chal ashtelech, wherever you're going to go. Now, I would have been, Yankev, I would have told Hashem, you know what, you want to help me? Give me a CD. Let me see my future. Imagine Shem tells me, you know, Yosef is going to disappear. Let me show you the CD. He's going to become king. You see the end, you know, end of the story. Everything is okay. Because, you know, all the tzoras, the Lavan, show the end of the story. Don't worry, you're going to become wealthy. I'll help you. His two wives, he wakes up in the morning instead of Rachel, it's Leah. Before Hashem told him the CD, he would have known. Hashem, let me tell you a very important thing. David the Melech asked Hashem, Hodi Eini Hashem Kitzi, please tell me my future. Rashi translated Masech to Shabbos, Kitzi means my future. Midas Yumayimahi, how long am I going to live? Hashem said to him, I don't tell anyone their future. I don't tell anyone how long they're going to live. No one knows how long they're going to live. It's amazing. Most important thing about your life, you don't know what's going to happen. You don't know how we're going to leave the world, when we're going to leave the world, and where we're going to leave this world. We don't know. And what's going to be, I don't say. But what Hashem did tell us, Hine unoichi imach, I am with you, not alone. Yishmartichem b'chol ashtelech. So this, to break it in reality, this is what the Hasidim, the Kabbalah, is to try to show people God is with us all the time. And once you believe and you work on this, then you can have a relationship. I always joke about it. I ask a person, do you love God? And they always says, you sound like a Baal Teshuva, you sound flaky, or I hate to say, you sound like Shlomo Kalman. Who talks about loving God? Now that's off the topic. In the Frum Olam, you don't talk about these things. Agidvart on the Pasha, this. Because Hashem is so removed from us. Someone recently told me that I think I saw on the table, but I overheard someone say, Rav Victor Miller used to say, always we get together, speak about God, speak about Hashem, say I love you. Because unfortunately, we could learn Torah all day long, but we don't have a relationship. But the Shem B'Choy did with the sister Torah and the Rizal and the Baal Shem Tov and Rav Nachman and all the great tzaddikim is to show Hashem is with us right now. And if you tell yourself Hashem is here, you'll feel it. One of the famous teaching of Nachman was, if you feel so far from Hashem, ask him, where are you? You ask Hashem, where are you? You'll find him. The famous ayah comes from the Hashem told the Marishim Ayeku, where are you? What have you done? When you ask yourself, what am I doing? What have you done? It awakens a person. And you ask, where is Hashem? You find Hashem. So what really this great tzaddik showed us, no matter how far gone a person is, there's no such a thing. A Yiddish and a Shema is always going to find us back to the Rabbani Shalom. So that's really why we celebrate the Shem B'Yachui, such an incredible leftover desire. You know, even saying desire, we believe that is B'tzachzach Neshama. The Ramchal, the Moshe Chaim Letzapet, the Mesila Shishurim, had a B'Semedrash, and he wanted us to meet, even they don't understand, just to read desire. That's such a power, the B'tzachzach Neshama. Even just reading desire. So, I want to encourage you all another thing. How does a person have a relationship with Hashem? The only way is, you got to make Hashem a reality. If you take time for yourself, you talk to the Rebbeinu Shel Olam. Take time, start with 20 minutes a day, sit in the room alone. and just say, I'm alone with Hashem, even if your mind wanders 100 times, I am here with God. And say, just say, here I am, Hashem. I would like to talk to you. And if you can't talk, just say, here, I would love to talk to you. Saying it out brings such a power to a person, empowers a person. So the Rebbeinu Shel Olam should help us all, that we should take strength of the Holy Reb Shem B'Yichui. And the strength should be the first thing we should be showing with the Bris Kodesh. We are such a challenge nowadays. It's really frightening. But the main thing is to have a relationship with Hashem. Take time, try it out. Take time, just sit. If you can't talk to Hashem, just sit here. I will often sit in my room. If I can't stop talking, say, hey, I'm sitting in the presence of Hashem. Here I am. And I just say, Rebbeinu Shel Olam, I would love to talk to you. I just don't know what to say to you today. Sometimes I am blank. So I tell Rebbeinu Shel Olam, you know, I came to talk to you. I am blank and I'm in a bad mood. And you know, I wish I'd be in a better mood. I wish I could express myself. And then slowly they will start talking. But you got to make a relationship with Hashem. How else are you going to love him? Anyways, I want to thank the people of Masada this year. Maybe she should help us, that we should zoicha to follow the ways of Hashem B'Yichui and to be happy. I want to tell you guys something. Today was a day for all of us. If you didn't smile today, who lost out of you not smiling today? Today's the end of the day. Ask yourself, today was a day. Imagine you would have been smiling all day long. Who would have gotten up? Whose day would have been better? Now, if you were in a bad mood today, you know who suffered? People around you. Because what we do is, when in a bad mood, we let other people have it. We let them have it. Now, if you were, you know what? You know, if you tell me, you know, I was in a bad mood today, it was geschmack. I was in a depressed day, and it was geschmack to be depressed. I got into a good fight with someone, and I always tell people, get into a good fight with someone. No one ever says, you know, that fight was a geschmack fight. You know what I mean? I feel so good about it. No, depression and angry, and no one feels good about it. So there's nothing holding us back. It's the curse of other Marishim, Eibu, Shibain, and that holds us back. Maybe she should help us. She was Zoycha to Simcha, Zoycha, Mashiach, Zatani, Amen. Amen.